The idea behind these themes is to look forward, and these are flexible themes where we can add new themes as they emerge.
The crops, roots and rhizosphere theme aims to manipulate the rhizosphere to the benefit of crop production. This includes manipulating root architecture and function in partner with the soil's natural microorganisms that reside on and around the crop root. Now, by fully harnessing the soil where roots grow, we will ensure we meet crop yield potentials. We believe that there's a significant opportunity to increase grain yields by ensuring the growth and the development of crop roots are not hindered by abiotic or biotic soil constraints. Furthermore, given our drying and warming climate, we need to continue to breed crops for heat tolerance, drought resistance and water use efficiency so as to lessen the impact of climate on our crops and farm businesses. Root and rhizosphere research is a new frontier compared to our knowledge of the above ground plant components. With our significant strength in root science and rhizosphere biology, the University of Western Australia has the expertise to meet the challenges of this field.
The sustainable grazing systems theme is about optimising the interaction between the genetics, the environment and management. So it's the right animals and plants in the right place, managed in the right way. If we can get this right, then we can maximise the profitability of producing clean, green and ethically produced products, which is what the consumers are demanding, with minimising the environmental footprint of livestock production. This is easier said than done, particularly when you consider the enormous area and the different types of grazing systems that we cover in this state. From the huge extensive grazing production or beef production systems and the rangelands up in the north, through to the mixed cropping and sheep production systems in the southern regions, and all combinations in between. We take a lab to landscape approach to tackle three key targets. The first one is to establish a feed base that's cost effective and as consistent in quality and quantity as possible all year round. The second is to improve the efficiency that ruminants convert that feed into product. And the third is improving reproductive efficiency. The sustainable grazing systems theme brings together the University of Western Australia's expertise in animal biology, in plant biology and agricultural economics to look at the system. And Western Australia clearly has an enormous potential for meat and wool production, and sustainable grazing systems as a system is a major component of that. In our approach, we're using everything from established scientific principles behind pasture systems and animal grazing behaviour to state-of-the-art genetic and genomic technologies to try and move closer to that optimal genetics by environment by management interaction. I guess most importantly, we collaborate with other universities and research organisations locally, nationally and internationally to ensure that the work that we do is the highest quality. But it also has the most impact for the producers whose livelihoods depend on us being innovative.
Water for Food Production aims to assist irrigators in optimising their water use to achieve maximum yield for least unit volume of water used. Essentially, plants require water as and when they need it, and irrigation systems must be able to be managed to take this into account to maximise production. Essentially, the use of smart sensor systems can assist farmers achieve these aims, and we are particularly interested in developing such systems at the University of Western Australia. In addition, in dryland systems, irrigation can lead to problems of salinity, and this must also be managed carefully. Again, sensors can play a role in this. The Institute of Agriculture has brought together scientists from across the university, from the faculties of science and engineering, to form coherent teams that can address these problems for the irrigation industry. We must also bear in mind that inefficient use of water can lead to off-site consequences to the environment that must be considered.
We have to remember when we're allocating water for irrigation that for every 1 litre of water we take out, there's potentially consequences to the aquifers or the rivers where we get this water from. This can include downstream impacts on wetlands and altered flows and water quality problems in downstream rivers. We therefore need to take a whole of system approach when we're looking at designing irrigation precincts to make sure that we can allocate water for food production while also meeting our environmental sustainability targets.
Increasing the intake of fruits, vegetables and whole grains is regarded as the foundation of dietary approaches to prevent chronic disease. The food quality and human health theme is exploring how fruits, vegetables and legumes might reduce the risk of chronic disease. Well, the major objective of that is to develop and release new apple varieties with enhanced health attributes. And this has involved collaboration with the apple industry and with other groups within the university, including Faculty of Medicine and Plant Sciences and the UWA Business School. Legume intake in Australia is very low. And one potential way of addressing that is to incorporate legumes and legume-derived food ingredients into commonly consumed staple foods such as bread. Our research has been looking at lupin and lupin flour as a food ingredient, and we've incorporated that into bread and a number of other foods, and we've found that they can improve blood pressure and improve the management of type 2 diabetes. A major aspect of the food quality and health theme is to develop new foods with potential to reduce chronic disease. The widespread consumption of these foods has the potential to benefit not only population health, but also agricultural industries.
An agribusiness ecosystem is a network of farms and organizations that come together so that they can be able to create value for their customers. Agribusiness ecosystem depends on or relies on the idea of the interdependence. The farms work together so that they can be able to survive in a very risky and competitive business environment. When we look at agriculture, we always think in terms of value chains and we think in terms of supply chains. But the concept of agribusiness ecosystem is a more unifying, integrated concept that helps us to look across the different industries, the different value chains, the different supply chains in a holistic way, so that we can be able to increase productivity, we can be able to increase profitability, and we can also be able to bring environmental sustainability in agriculture. The main focus of this theme is going to be research that is relevant to the needs of the industry, that responds to the changing times, and also training by emphasizing both soft and hard skills that are relevant for the development of the agribusiness industry.
The University of Western Australia is currently ranked 25th in the world in agriculture and life science and number one in Australia. We encourage bright and talented students to come to this wonderful university to undertake undergraduate and postgraduate programs in agriculture science and food production systems.